Hello everyone and welcome back to Dentrixtry. Today we are going to be discussing the infamous topic of centric relation, centric occlusion and maximum intercuspation. This video will help you solve the doubts and confusion you have of this topic. First, we begin with the current definition of centric relation. It is defined as a maxillomandibular relationship independent of tooth contact in which the condyles articulate in the anterior superior position against the posterior slopes of the articular eminence. In this position, the mandible is restricted to a purely rotary movement. From this unstrained physiologic maxillomandibular relationship, the patient can make vertical, lateral, or protrusive movements. It is a clinically useful, repeatable reference position. Wow, that was complicated. So, let us break it down for easier understanding. A maxillomandibular relationship, or your jaw relationship, independent of tooth contact. Now, this is very important. Centric relation, you have to remember, is that it is a bone-to-bone relationship, that is, mandible-to-maxilla relation, which is not dependent on your teeth. That means it doesn't matter if the teeth are present or not. The next sentence mentions the relation of your condyle with the articular disc, in which the condyles articulate in the anterior superior position against the posterior slopes of the articular eminences. This is the anatomical reference which we can understand with the help of this diagram. This is the articular disc, your condyle, and the articular eminence. So your condyle is in an anterior superior position against the posterior slope of the articular eminence. Next, while in centric relation, the mandible is restricted to a purely rotary movement. So here, first you need to know that all mandibular movements are divided into either rotation or translation. Rotation happens when the head of the condyle rotates around an imaginary horizontal or transverse axis. It is a simple hinge movement within the socket. This transverse axis is known as the hinge axis, and it is an imaginary line which passes from the center of one condyle to the other. Rotation is restricted to only the first 20 millimeters of mouth opening. Beyond that, if you want to open your mouth wider, the condyle has to slide out of the socket forwards and downwards along the articular eminence. This movement is called as translation. Moving forward, we have these terms as well, unstrained and physiologic. Centric relation is considered to be the most comfortable and orthopedically stable position. Why is centric relation useful? It is because it is a repeatable reference position. For example, in an edentulous patient who has no teeth, we always take centric relation as a reference for the teeth arrangement, because it can be repeated and can be found consistently. This makes it popular for clinicians. Coming to maximum intercuspation, it is defined as the complete intercuspation of the opposing teeth independent of condylar position, sometimes referred to as the best fit of the teeth regardless of the condylar position. In simple terms, maximum intercuspation or MIP is the way your teeth occlude or meet when you bite. And remember, this does not have anything to do with your centric relation. So it doesn't matter if the condyle is or is not in centric relation. It is a position of habitual closure. Moving on, let us look at another definition, centric occlusion. It is defined as the occlusion of opposing teeth when the mandible is in centric relation. This may or may not coincide with the maximal intercuspal position. Is centric occlusion or CO same as MIP? A concept that is often confused with. So let us again go back to basics. Centric relation is the condylar position. Centric occlusion is the occlusion of the teeth when the condyles are in centric relation. So these two are interrelated. Whereas maximum intercuspation is the best fit of the teeth. It does not depend on centric relation. Simple? I hope you have now understood the basic idea behind the three. Now, a very common question. Why is centric relation so important? Why is it considered as the most stable position? For this, we need to first understand the basic TMJ anatomy. Very briefly, I'm not getting into the intricate details of the same, but only the part relevant to this topic. So we have the condyle, which is a part of the mandible, the glenoid fossa, this slope being the articular eminence. Between the two parts is the avascular structure, which is the articular disc, on which the condyle rests. As already discussed, since it is devoid of nerves and vessels, any amount of compression on this disc by the condyle will not result in pain. However, behind the disc, you have the retrodiscal tissue, which is highly innervated. So if your disc is pulled forward because of any pathology or trauma, that is when the pain starts. Then you have the most important muscle, that is the lateral pterygoid. You have the superior belly of the lateral pterygoid, which is attached to the anterior part of the disc, and the inferior belly of the lateral pterygoid, which is attached to the neck of the condyle. Now, you have to understand that at all times, it is essential that your inferior lateral pterygoid remains in a relaxed state when your teeth are in occlusion to have a harmony between your temporomandibular joint, the masticatory muscles, and your teeth. Now, this brings us to understanding the system in which the teeth work and the concept of coordinated and incoordinated muscle function. So when all this is in harmony, you have something called as a coordinated muscle function. Like already mentioned, release of the inferior belly of lateral pterygoid during mouth closure or during elevator muscle contraction is the goal for occlusal harmony. Such coordinated muscle function is possible only if the condyle disc assemblies seat up comfortably in centric relation. And in turn, like we've already learned, if the condyle disc assembly is in centric relation, the occlusion that we have is centric occlusion. But if the condyles are getting displaced to achieve maximum intercuspation, which happens in the case of a deflective incline like a high crown, the inferior lateral pterygoid must actively contract to hold the condyles down on an incline in a direct opposition to the contraction of all elevator muscles every time the teeth are brought to maximum contact. This resultant hypercontraction of all masticatory muscles is known as an incoordinated muscle function and is a cause of pain in the masticatory system. So in short, in absence of deflective tooth inclines, the condyles are completely seated in centric relation. The inferior lateral pterygoid is completely relaxed and is inactive even during clenching. And that, my friends, is why centric relation is so important and is termed as the musculoskeletally stable position. Moving on, I'm sure many of you are aware about the centric relation to maximum intercuspal position slide or CRMIP slide. So what happens when there is a CRMIP slide? Again, a very common question. You need to know that 90% of the time, you will find a slide from your centric relation position to maximum intercuspal position. There is always approximately a 0.5 to 2 mm slide. So does that mean that we should correct this and bring the patient's occlusion to coincide with centric relation? For example, if I have a bridge to place and I find out that the patient has a shift from centric relation to MIP, do I equilibrate the entire occlusion to centric relation? Because as we've learned, centric relation is the most stable position? No, not at all. You can go ahead and fix the bridge retaining the same occlusion as the patient has no complaints and is comfortable with the already existing occlusion. So what are the clinical applications of centric relation? Clinically, centric relation is used when the maximum intercuspal position is unhealthy in case of occlusal disease, pain in the masticatory musculature, when the patient does not have stable tooth contacts, and when the occlusal vertical dimension is being altered. To understand when to use centric relation, an evaluation of restorative needs and evidence of occlusal disease must be considered. Symptoms of occlusal disease may include wear, fractures, crack, fremitus, mobility, dentine exposure, affraction, joint pain, muscle pain, recession, and loss of vertical dimension of occlusion. If you happen to find any of these in your patient, then it is preferred to restore in centric relation. Question: in what routine case is centric relation necessary? Complete dentures, isn't it? Because in your edentulous patient, you do not have an occlusal guide. So you record the centric relation and then arrange your teeth in centric occlusion. Other cases where centric relation is necessary are full mouth rehabilitation, implant prosthesis with multiple missing teeth, cases where there is no vertical stop which inevitably results in loss of occlusal vertical dimension, for example a long edentulous span in any one of the arches with missing posterior teeth like Kennedy's class 1 or class 2, or when all the teeth in at least one arch are being treated. When is it not necessary to rehabilitate the patient's occlusion according to centric relation? So there are several times when your maximum intercuspal position is healthy and reliable. For example, your routine crown or bridge, single implants, etc. You don't really have to go ahead and change the occlusion. Maintain the same occlusion that the patient already has because the patient is comfortable in that occlusion. Another reason for not using centric relation is when there is an active degenerative joint disease like arthritis. So with this, we come to an end. I really hope this video has helped you clear your doubts and misconception about the topic. I request you to share the video and please subscribe to the channel for more such amazing dental videos. To summarize the whole discussion, centric relation is merely a therapeutic or treatment position. When a tooth-based determinant of occlusion is not or cannot be used, a joint-based determinant should be used, that is, centric relation. This is considered to be the most orthopedic position of the mandible due to resultant skeletal and muscular harmony. Clinically, centric relation is used when maximum intercostal